The Leonids are an annual meteor shower notable for delivering occasional powerful meteor storms. Tempel-Tuttle is the parent comet of the Leonids, and it completes one orbit every 33 years. When a comet approaches the sun, it sheds dust and particles, and when the Earth's orbit crosses this debris path, a meteor shower will be the result. Every year, the Leonids peak around November 17th and 18th. This shower appears to radiate from the constellation of Leo, hence the name Leonids. The radiant point is near the brilliant star of Regulus in the constellation of Leo. Meteor showers are caused by microscopic comet pieces, primarily made of dust and small pebbles, and when they enter the Earth's atmosphere, they burn up due to the friction in the air. Meteor showers are observable from Earth, as well as those in orbit above the Earth, and they often display fantastic light streaks across the sky. The Leonids are famous for their spectacular fireballs and extremely rapid meteors. They have been also observed to create meteor storms, which are periods of unusually intense meteor activity. These storms can produce hundreds, if not thousands, of meteors every hour. Meteor storms occur when the Earth travels through an area of a comet's debris track that is unusually thick, and the Leonids have a lengthy history of observation that are linked to some of history's most spectacular meteor outbursts. Significant storms have been recorded in 1833 and 1966. So why do meteor showers appear to radiate from one area of the sky? This is an effect of perspective, which is similar to parallel railroad tracks that converge at a single vanishing point on the horizon when you view it from the middle. Because the particles in a meteor shower are all moving in parallel courses at the same velocity, they will appear to radiate from a single point to an observer who is photographing them. Thus, meteor showers are typically named after the constellation in which the meteors appear to originate from. Now, if you look at this photograph, it's a 4-hour time lapse of a meteor shower. If you trace all these points back to the original point, that's where the radiant would be. And remember, when you're viewing a meteor shower, you're not going to notice this radiant effect. It's really only when you're photographing them, and you'll just see random streaks of light that randomly appear in the sky as you are observing them. It happens so quickly, for like a fraction of a second. You can simply blink and miss a meteor. Please let me know in the comments section below. Have you seen any meteors from the Leonids in your region of the world? This shower lasts about 1 month and peaks in mid-November, so there is a large window of opportunity to see it. I wish you clear skies from wherever you're viewing the sky from. Often the greatest challenging is having clear weather to even view the event. I try to go out in the early morning hours. It often provides the best time for viewing. It's very quiet, and I just love that time of day. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, keep looking up.